Listen up, viewers, we've got important news for you. One of these days, you're gonna die. Well, hopefully it's not gonna happen today, so now that we've caught you while you're living, we wanna hit you with some science so that you're aware of what goes on after you're gone. Let's say hypothetically that you were to just slump over dead in your chair right now. So what happens next? Well, because your heart is no longer pumping, your blood stops flowing and coagulates, forming clots and becoming really thick and lumpy. As your blood is no longer circulating, it settles where gravity forces it to, a process called postmortem hypostasis, or rigor mortis. Without circulation, your body temperature also drops, and your muscles stiffen in a process known as rigor mortis. Now, obviously, you aren't breathing anymore. No respiration means no oxygen is getting to your cells, and without oxygen in your cells, the mitochondria inside can't make ATP, a chemical used for a host of cellular tasks. If your cells can't make ATP, your cells stop working, or in other words, they're dead. With your cells now kaput, they start to break down and release all sorts of stuff, including enzymes. That makes for an environment that is very attractive to bacteria and fungi, which eventually enter the mix and start decomposing or putrefying the body. This process certainly isn't pretty, but it's definitely normal. Before you're buried or cremated, your family may want a funeral. To slow down the decomposition process and keep you looking tidy, chemistry comes in handy via a process called embalming. The embalming process happens in two steps. First, your body is going to be loaded full of preservative chemicals like formaldehyde or glutaraldehyde using a pump and your circulatory system. Next, all of your stomach contents get sucked out and all the dark nether regions untouched by the circulatory system are filled up with the same chemicals. While the embalming process does offer more time for your family to bid farewell to a you that mostly looks like you, it is only temporary, then it's back to decomposition. During the decomposition process, a huge array of chemical byproducts are spewed out by bacteria. Two in particular, putrescine and cadaverine, smell absolutely disgusting. I mean, really, they smell like a dead body. Sulfur-containing compounds are also produced, which reek like rotten egg and skunk, along with countless other gases that work together to temporarily make you more bloated than you ever were while living. Okay, so we've heard that some say that your hair and nails keep growing after you die. Well, let's see what mortician/YouTuber Caitlin Doughty from the Order of Good Death has to say about that.
The hair on your head grows a tiny amount every day, but when you die, those processes stop. For thousands of years, people thought that the dead's hair and fingernails kept growing after death because that's what it looked like to the naked eye. But it's not that the hair and nails are growing, it's that the rest of your body is shrinking. When you die, your body dehydrates, and the formerly moisturized, plump skin shrivels, revealing not growth, but what was already there to begin with.
So hopefully now you've got a good sense of what happens when you can sense no more. And while it may seem like a dark topic, just remember, live life to the fullest. Learn more chemistry while you still can. Do yourself a favor and hit that subscribe button. And be sure to check out Caitlin's channel too for more facts about the end of your life. She's also got an awesome new book out, and the link's in the description down below. Click that button on the right to subscribe to her channel. Big shout out to ACS Webinars for hooking us up with the Chemistry of Death webinar. These folks have got tons of cool chem videos. Subscribe to their channel, learn something new, and we'll see you again soon, chem heads.